Do we need grouting for space invaders? Hey, what up, people? I received a very functional and a very cool question, which was about mosaic art, especially this space invader mosaic art, which is a kind of a mosaic art. I felt always cool to that space invader thing because it's mosaic art. It's almost 6,000 years old, and there's street art because space invaders are located in streets, spread everywhere, all around the world almost. And it's an important topic because it brings somehow two disciplines together, which is street art culture and the innocent culture, which is the mosaic, which I will be also invited from university to talk about these two disciplines, how they came together and stuff like that. I'm not kidding, I will be invited very soon, by the way. Let's get into the topic. Okay, let's start with this. First things first, if you still don't know how to make space invader by using glass mosaic tiles, watch that one video that I released. There are a lot of, but I released also one which I made of space invader in almost, I guess, in 20 minutes or something like that. I will write the video link in the description below. I don't have any space invader right here in the studio. I'm not able to build one because I don't have any glass mosaic inside the studio, but I've got this one. That's a stormtrooper. Anyway, I made this in the same technique. I have this mesh that's kind of a mesh. It's like, we say mosaic mesh, it can be used for many reasons. I still even have that paper, you know, that's the drawing. If you follow the lines and glue your tiles, you will have exactly the shape that you have on your paper right here. It's just, you have to think like a mirror. You see, it's looking to the left on my side, and when it's done, it looks to the right. So keep in mind that you need that mirror effect before you start the mosaic. Why we have to grout a mosaic? Well, it is actually holding these pieces together, if you know what I mean. Hold on. So you see these pieces? These are 1 by 1 centimeter and almost 7 millimeter thickness. What it does, that grouting is flowing between the tiles, and also you see the spaces, you see that mesh? So it fills up the spaces and it's actually holding each tile like this. Who the hell is that? Hello? Ignat. Okay, what was I saying? Okay, that grouting is holding the tiles by filling the sides, you know, each side of each mosaic tile will get holded by that grouting thing. So with this, it is holding the tile. Why these tiles are needs to get hold? It's already glued, stick it, you know, on, and it's not easy to get one of these things out. It's not that possible, it's not that easy. The point is, when you are laying this kind of a thing on streets, I mean, you know, exterior stuff, there is something will produce a lot of problems to this mosaic, which is actually water, comes with the rain and snow and things like that. If you want to have your space invader on the street somewhere for a very, very long time, you need to consider about this grouting thing, but it's not enough. Even if you would grout it before you stick it on the wall, because you will not have a lot of time to stick it and then grouting and then clean up the grout, and you have your police right behind your neck. So it must be very speedy, you know, if you know what I mean. The point is, if you make a grout and then you're gonna glue it somewhere, stick it on a wall, on a street, it will not help us further. Let's say that's a wall, okay, from a police station, and you're gonna apply your tile on a wall. So what happens is, when some water is, after the rain, is flowing from that wall, it will definitely,
let's go to a real wall. I would love to go and stick that mosaic somewhere, this stormtrooper dropper somewhere on a wall in real time as a street art activity, but I'm quite new in this province, so I don't know where they have cameras, and that's why I had to show this in a studio on a studio wall. So excuse me for that, but the next time we definitely gonna make some space emitters and we're gonna stick them somewhere.
So let's say that's a wall somewhere in London or wherever you are, and you put some silicone or something, if you know what I mean, or some kind of adhesive glue material, and you stick it and you move it a little bit, and then you know it's stable and you can leave it and run away before someone comes and catch you. So the problem is, don't forget the question, it was about, do we need grouting? Is it better to grout that space invader and then glue it somewhere? Actually, it's not, because grouting is to hold the tiles, but the thing is, you need also some cement-based adhesive, if you know what I mean. I mean, like, you need to handle this like you are doing mosaic or ceramics in a bathroom. So it's impossible, you know. You need that stuff to roll that stuff on a wall, that cement-based adhesive, and glue it, and you need to go like that. Then you have to wait until it gets, you know, dry, and then you need to need your grout and stuff. So grouting is actually to give your mosaic a very long-term life on that wall, because of we need some simple adhesives to stick that space invader or something like that on a wall outside on a street. It doesn't make any sense to grout it. The tiles will get fall anyway, because the water, which is, you know, we are outside right now, think like that. And if it's somewhere, if you have some rain or snow, that water will come like this, and it will definitely go under our mosaic somehow, you know, behind our mosaic, and our mosaic will start to fall off after a long while. But I want to tell you this, there are very strong adhesives for outside usage. If you use one of them, your mosaic will have a very long-term life at that wall. We actually, what I'm going up to is, if it's not a commission or something like that, is it just a street art? You don't need any grouting. Even, you know, you will change the look totally, because it's not easy to find the colors and stuff. It will look okay, but technically it will not bring us a step further. But what it does actually, if you could grout it before you stick it somewhere on a wall, so when people wants to damage your work, they can use this kind of a thing, and they will go like, if you know what I mean, to damage it. But when you have some grout, they can't. If you have some grout, they can't reach the spaces here, so they can't damage your work. What you can do actually, when you want to have your space invader over there, wherever it is, outside, for a very long time, you should think about not use silicone, but there are much, much stronger and effective adhesives on the market. These are tubes, you know, you just press that thing, that one thing, and you're gonna glue it. The easiest way, if you are a very important location where you don't have time to play it around, make sure that you have your adhesive, which I told you, at the edges first, and then just make an X, and then one like this and one like that. This will help to your mosaic, your space invader, to stay there for a very long time. So why are these edges important? Because this is the first location where that water will try to, you know, that rain, and its temperature changes, temperature is changing from day to night. So all this water will not have a chance to get behind your, under your mosaic, and can't damage your thing. So, but the most important thing is actually, when you stick your mosaic tiles on a mesh or on something else, I don't know what you guys using, I'm using a mesh. Mosaic mesh can be found on Amazon easily. The thing is, actually don't use silicone to glue it. Why? Because silicone can have this gummy effect, you know, it will like a bubble gum, and it is moving, and silicone is actually not a technical adhesive. It has You can practice it. Just stick something with silicone on glass piece. You know, our stuff is shiny. That's why it is a problem. Just stick it somewhere and you will see a couple of months later, you can just, you know, pull it off. You can just take it off from that surface, from that substrate very easily. There is one thing more to protect your space invader, actually. And that is, if you use mosaic mesh, if you use that mesh to glue it on, most people are using water-based adhesive because there is no smell and nothing like that, so it's easy to manage and it will get dry in a couple of, in 1 or 2 hours. The thing is, use an adhesive to stick your tiles during your workshop, you know, when you're sticking the ceramic tiles or mosaic tiles, glass mosaic tiles on your mesh. Use something which will not get in reaction with water. Why? Because this will definitely help when some water outside wants to get under your mosaic. And the problem is, okay, let me go this way. Water-based adhesive is getting in reaction with water. There are also other adhesive types which we are using during our creating of our space invader. When it gets in reaction with water, the tiles will, you know, after a strong rain, our tiles will get lost, if you know what I mean. Because after the reaction with that water, with our adhesive, that adhesive will lose his ability to use something different. There are solvent stuff, you know, which smells quite bad, but it doesn't get in reaction with water. So it's good to use it outside. And this is all I can say. The stuff that I made is still there. I know it's almost, I guess, more than 1 year ago, and that stuff is still there. I saw it last weekend. I used actually water-based adhesive and just a silicone, but that stuff is still there. I even don't worry when it fell off somehow. It will not hurt someone because I located it that way that if he falls, it will not damage someone's head. This is also what we have to consider before we glue that stuff on streets. So in short, we don't need to grout our space invader. It's just the excitement. Just stick it there, stick as much as you can. And I'm gonna leave this toilet right now. Excuse me for that, cause the sound is over. Yes, it's over. It was quite loud. So
thanks for the question. And it was a cool question. So I hope I could help you a bit with this video. See you next time.